design team, and I thought I would share it with you guys in case you wanted to make it. So I have made all the boxes bar two, so I thought I'd make two with you. Move that a bit so you can see it, and then we make the cover, and then obviously then after that we can just stick it in, so it'd be a lot easier. So I'm going to get on with it. So for everyone that finds easier with the instructions, I have wrote them down so you can screenshot them. So you, for the boxes, you're, I don't know why, but for this specific one you need to have 24. Okay, so you need to make 24 boxes, and you need to have it to be 7 1/4 by 8.5 inches, or if you work in centimeters, it's 18 centimeters by 22 centimeters. And then we need to score along the long side at 1 5/8, 4 5.5, and 7 7/8, or 4, 10, 14, and 20 centimetres, okay? And then on the short side, we're going to do 7/8 of an inch, 2 3/8, 4 3/4, and 6 1/4. And then in centimetres, we're going to do 2, 6, 12, and 16, okay? And I did work it all out. It took me a while. So we're going to make... Well, I've already cut mine, so we're just going to score it. Just need to find my scoring tool. There we go. Okay. So on the long side, we want 1 5/8, because I do work in inches. 4 5.5 and 7 7/8. And then we turn it to the short side, and we will score at 7/8. And put you down a little bit more just so you can see. So 7/8, 2 3/8, 4 3/4, and 6 1/4. I'm just gonna do one more. Okay. I should know these measurements by now, but so again, 1 5/8. 4 5.5 and 7 7/8, and then the last ones 7 8 2 3/8, 4 3/4 and 6 1/4. Or 6 1/4. Yeah, so that's done. Let's get to cone. So I have, to make it easier for you, I have done a diagram. I'm hoping you'll be able to see it on here. But, so what you want to do is, this is what we're going to have. So, we're gonna, so ours is gonna look like this because it's big R. Okay, so originally, first of all, what you want to do, oh, I need to put it in the right place first, that would help. You want to get rid of this and this and this. So there's a square here, 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 and here. So that's here, 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 and here, and then there's a square here. Okay, and then you do exactly the same here, but you leave one square here and one square there, okay? And we'll do this bit in a minute. Just ignore them for a minute, okay? And then up here, here, is another square, so you get rid of that. So, we've got a... So, I'll just show you here. So, square, rectangle... Kind of like a rectangle, and then you get rid of this bit, okay? Like that, and then it's on the top, so you do that on the opposite side, and then here again, just one square, just remove it, okay? So that's what we want to do first of all. I hope that makes sense. Okay, so I'm gonna just lift you up a little bit, just so you're not as close. I'm gonna use my new scissors, which are amazing. So I do actually have an easier way to do this, but just for video purposes, I'm just going to show you this way, and then maybe on the other one I'll show you. Okay. Okay, like that. Okay, I've got a little tiny bin next to me. Well, it's a pot that I'm using as a bin. Okay, so I need to see the light. There we go. Okay, so we have this, okay? And then what you want to do, it has to be this way, okay? You have to have this bit here. So then you're going to go down like that. And you're going to wedge. And again, you're going to wedge. And then, obviously, you want to wedge these. You don't have to, it makes it easier. And again, you're going to wedge. And you're going to wedge. Okay, so now it looks like this. We've got our little bit there. And then you go to the other side where this bit's here. And again, you're gonna wedge and wedge. So you just kind of want it to look exactly the same. I have got a little bit of pen, but that's okay. I don't mind. Okay. So, let's get rid of this into my little bin. And I'm going to do the other one just a little bit quicker. I'll leave that there just so you can see how I'm doing this. Just so you know, because obviously you have a small end here and then you have a large end here. Where you have the small end is where you cut the four squares, okay? So this is the way I do it. I cut up, you have to cut up straight on here because there's no wedge. And then what I do, because this is going to be a wedge, I just cut straight down as a wedge, like that. Obviously, here I go straight because you don't want it. Oh no, here I go for a wedge again. And then I cut that. I didn't do that on the other one, but we will be cutting it. Silly me. I'll show you on the other one in a minute. Forgot that bit. There we go. Oops, that weren't supposed to happen, was it? Well, that's what happened when you're not paying attention. Right, I will do another one of that. Just give me a second. So, you want to cut these as wedges, okay? But it's exactly the same. I can't believe I just did that. But I'm not going to take it out because it just goes to show you that you have to pay attention to what you're cutting. And you know, that's the first one that's happened to me like that. So did I go wrong? Just trying to think now if I actually did go wrong or if it's my brain telling me I did. Yeah, I did. I forgot what I did. I accidentally took this bit out, which I shouldn't have, but that's my problem. I will make another one. Give me 1 second. Okay, so we have another one. Let's try again, shall we? It's because I'm on camera. Everything goes wrong when you're on camera. We need this bit, apart from that little wedge here and here. We take that bit off and that bit, so that looks like that. Filming shot. Okay, so that is what we need. Just fold all the edges as best you can. You can do this neater if you want, but after you've done 24, it gets a bit tiring. Right, I've only just made the 24 today. No, my hand's all covered, so. I've got my two. Okay. So then we're going to build them. So the way we build them. Oh, that way. Oh, just go. Fold this one, sorry. So it's the one I didn't go wrong on. No cats outside. No. Little chat. Okay, so that is them, and then let's get covered in more glue. Okay, I'm just cleaning my ball quick. Oh, all over me. Okay, there we go. Gonna open this slowly. I really do need to buy some more smaller bottles. Mine, I stupidly put Premier construction glue from Hunky Dory in it, and do not do it. Do not. I don't know if anyone has done it, but. For the life of me, it's so thick that I can't get out of my bottle. Like, it's just ridiculous. I have squeezed that thing until I'm blue in the face. It just does not want to come out. So now I have glue stuck in a little tiny glue bottle and I can't use it. Which is sad because it's good glue. Don't get me wrong, just don't stick them in little balls because they ain't coming out. Right. Have I? Yeah. Got it here. So this bottle's full and there's nothing. Let me just get this out. I think I can't get my needle out. I'll do it later. But yeah, it's a struggle. Oopsie. Okay. Then just fold down them sides in. And If you wanted to, you can snip this. I prefer not to. I like to have it. I like the strength of the bottle lid closing better. There we go. Don't know why it's been all weird, but yeah, so like that. And then we'll make one more. Well, we made it, but we just do the glue. Okay, I'm going to do this and then I'll come back. Okay, so I am now trying to make as much room as possible on my desk. Okay, so I don't know how this is going to work yet, but I need so much room, it's ridiculous. Okay, I cut it off a little bit, but you're going to need one piece, which is 8 1/4 by 11, and you need one, or 21 centimeters by 28 centimeters. Okay, and that's this big one here. And then you are going to need two pieces of 8 1/4 by 5 1/4, or in centimeters is 21 by 14. And then you need two pieces again, which are 8 1/4 by 3 3/8, or that's supposed to be 21 centimeters by 8.5. Do not copy the two. Let me quickly change that. So one. Okay. So 21 by 8.5, and that's this one here. So they all fit. Okay, so I'm just going to put that there while I get my paper out. Okay, so that if you wanted to, if you don't want to do it the way I'm doing it, you could generally just use your paper and then join them together using binder strips. And you would do that by, I'll show you, but I think I'm gonna need three. So I'm doing it the album way, but if you wanted to do it the binder strip way, you would cut this let me just do it. So cut this to about 2 inches, okay, and then and score this at 1 inch, or fold it in half, whatever you prefer. Okay, you would do that, and then what you would do is you will bind that like that. And like that, but you would still need to make sure that you have that gap so that your album will fold. If you put them like that, that is not going to fold and it will break. So you just still need to make sure that you have your slight gap. And if you don't know how to make a gap in your work, you can just get one of your bits, put this in the middle, and then you've got your thing, okay? And then once you've done that, you need to do the inside as well. So you do the outside and you do the inside. So, for example, you would have that there on it. So you would have that like that on both sides. So you have one inside, one out, so like that. Okay? I'm not going to do that because I'm strange and have to do it the long-ass way. Sorry for swearing, YouTube. So I think I'm gonna need three across. I might need bigger room. I have two at the minute. I thought I had three. This is so you wanna put this together here at around about half an inch and tape it. I'm just gonna check. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna need another one. Okay. I am trying to make as much room as possible. Okay, do you know what? I'm gonna go off and I'm gonna make this album. But to show you what I have, I will quickly show you one side actually of me doing it, because I would need to be able to do it. I know a lot of you have already made albums, so a lot of you should know, but there is some people I knew that probably won't know how to make an album. So I have my three pieces. I am gonna join them. It's so long, my table's not big enough. Well, it is big enough, but I have so much stuff on it. Okay. So I haven't stuck it down yet, just because I want to show you. So we are going to have this, like, here. Actually, I want it more over, because I want it to be over this line. If you can see, there's a line here where they join up. I want that to be over this, because... And then the next piece will go over that. So, where did I put the pieces? Okay. So then on this side, you're going to have one small piece, which will be here. Okay. And then you're going to have your longer piece here. So I'm just going to move this over. I'm going to move this piece of paper. And I'm going to move this over slightly. So this is how one side of your album will look, okay? So you're going to have one here and one here, okay? And again, if you don't want to use your chipboard, you could just put a ruler in the middle. And again, you'll know how far. Okay, so you would do exactly the same as this on the other side, okay? And that's, so if you've not made an album, this is how we are making this album. But if you're new, I would suggest maybe doing it the other way, because it might be easier for you. But yeah, this is very, very long. I don't know any other way of showing you how to do it. But yeah, I'm now going to stick all my sides together. And then I will come back for the last bit to show you how to do that if you've not made albums before, because then I can show you how I've laid it out once it's laid out. Okay, so I'll be back in about, well, for you it'd be a click. Oh, I forgot to say, I am putting this double-sided tape on mine. You could use glue, but again, it might take longer. So to bind my pages together, I am just using this. My hands are so sticky. Oh my goodness. Sorry, everyone. There we go. Right. So I'm just going to make sure that this is perfectly straight. Just by taking a little bit off. There we go. So then you want to hold it. Oh, that broke now. Ah, oh, missions. Okay, so I have done my, I've put tape all around my edges, and for the middle I'm going to use glue. I have kind of placed where they're going to go to make sure it will fit all around. And I've got, this is so much easier to use than my fingers, because they'll... Okay, there we go. Let's say that and it's not coming up. There we go. Put my pen. Okay, so now I'm going to put my glue. I lose everything when I'm crafting. Does anyone else? Oh, it's because I moved everything off my desk as well, so that really hasn't helped. Okay. This is really strong glue, which is nice as well. You can put that around the edges if you want as well. Gives you a bit of wiggle room if you need it. Okay. So that's just double make sure that everything goes. Okay. I'm trying to make this as straight as possible. It's not. Placing the first one is not the biggest deal. The biggest deal is making sure the others are straight. Okay? It doesn't matter if there's a bit of spillage because that's going to wrap it anyway. Okay. I'm going to move this now. Now the first bit is stuck down. I can try and wiggle it so I can show you. Again. If you do want a straight edge, then use a ruler. As best you can. Okay. Again, I'm just taking my tape off. If you've followed my channel for a while, then you know I love making advent calendars. I try and make one every year actually, but this is the only one I'll be making this year. My daughter doesn't not really into advent calendars as much. No, she likes the okay. Just double check here as well. Yeah, it's perfect, I think. Yeah, perfect. Okay, so just gonna make sure we just push that down really hard because it has got glue on it. Okay, I'm gonna try and move it a bit more. It's so hard, my desk is not big enough, honestly. Okay. If I'm not in camera, it's just, I'm sorry, it's just easier to sometimes to take it off when close to my face for some reason. I don't know why I do that. Right, there we go. One more. And then I will do the other side. Sometimes it's horrible when it just doesn't stick. There we go. Okay. So this side is done. There is a lot of overhang on this side, so I will be chopping it off when I find my scissors. Oh yeah, I'll put them back. No, I can't cut straight, so probably won't be a straight line. Thank God for paper trimmers, to be honest. It doesn't have to be straight. You really aren't going to see it, so it's not that bad. Okay, so I'm going to flip and then add these on, and I will come back. Okay, so we're back. Okay, so now what we want to do is take off our corners. I do have a tool that I like to use for that. So you just line that up, and then you can get a pencil and just draw it. I'm just going to use it today and just pray I'm straight. There we go. And then just cut it. There we go. And then I'm going to do that on all four sides. Hopefully, again, I'm in shot. So I'm just lining this edge. I can't remember what tool this is called. Right. Oh, this is. I should really draw around it, but. I'm trying to be quicker, but I think the other way would actually be quicker. It's okay. Okay. Let's just. That would do. Yeah, we're done good. Okay. I'm going to do that on the other side. I'm actually just going to draw it. It's so much easier. Not so much quicker, but easier. Okay. You want to line this one up with that one. It doesn't have to fit all the way across, because you can just go from there. There we go. You're not going to see the lines. We want to fold our edges up. Okay, so I'm going to try something new. I've not done this before. I'm praying this is going to work. So because this is so big, it's going to be so difficult to fold. So you normally would fold all this. Ugh, I don't know if I want to try it. So the way I was thinking is to draw a line here and then have that going over. So just draw like a small triangle. I'm just worried if I do it, you're going to see the white, and I hate seeing the white. Do you know, I'm just going to try and do it the hardest way, the complicated way, because for some reason I like to do things a lot complicated. So you just want to, if you don't want to do that, you could generally just, so where you've got your line here, you could just do a small slit like that, and then the bit that will go up like that. Okay, and then obviously then you have that other bit, and then you do like the same again, like just showing you roughly this, and then obviously that would go up like that. So that's how. I'm worried if I do it I'm gonna mess it up, so I'm obviously, you won't mess it up. I'm just, I've never done it that way. I have seen people do it that way though. and it didn't mess up, but I want to be able to there we go. I did it. I don't know how. Well, I'm gonna do this on this end. And you just wanna just gently go up. You don't wanna go too hard at first. You just wanna and then push it down. There we go. Right. And then obviously this bit is so much easier to do. You just lift it up and push. So I'm now going to put my tape on. Oh, this is huge. We're getting to the place now where we can sort this out and get it done to the point where we can see the whole thing. So I'm just going to do a bit of the top and a bit of the bottom, and then that should be enough. You could do one in the middle as well, which I'm probably am going to do just to make it more strength, but you really don't have to. If you wanted to, you could just use glue. I'm really sorry if I'm not in shot. I am just going to do one side. You want to start with the long side first as well. I'm going to do one side and then I will do the other side off camera so I don't bore you with... Look how long that is. That's how long this album is. Crazy long. I don't know what made me want to do an album this long, but... I did see someone do something like this. Not exactly like mine. Ugh. Another one. Right, I'm on the last bit. Oh. There we go. Let's put that in again. Just gonna go over with a bit of glue. Not too much glue, because I don't want it warping. There we go. And you start from the middle again. And you push down. And then you push out. Okay? It's really important that you do it like that. So I'm going to do the other side and I'll come back when I'm doing the last little bit. Okay, so on the last little bit now. It doesn't matter if it goes over the edge, just... Add my glue. Don't forget to push these in. They don't have to be perfect, but you don't want you really don't want to have a spiky edge, especially if you're giving this away. I'm just gonna pushing it down a little bit, making sure it's all good. Okay. Now I need to find my ruler. Nothing new there. Okay, I'm just gonna use this one. I have hundreds of rulers. The one I just had has disappeared. Okay. So So what we want to do now, so I'm going to line that up to here. And you just want to have a little bend in on all these. I'm going to do this side first, just to make it easier for me. I might be able to get it in frame then for you guys. There we go. And then I'm going to put a ruler here and just, that will stick just because it's got glue on it as well. Just gently, do not push it up or you will bend, or you will break it. Okay. There we go. You will break the spine on the other side if you rip it, if you do not do it gently. Okay, so it's going to go like that. How cool! Right, I'm going to turn it over. And we're going to do exactly what we just did on the other side. Just don't push too hard, because obviously, again, you do not want to rip this. And there's nothing holding this bit together, because this bit's the middle of the chipboard, okay? If you find this a bit boring when I'm just doing that, then obviously feel free to skip, but I'd rather make sure my spine didn't break. which is a really scary thing after all this process, you know, and your spine breaking. I would honestly cry. And oh my god, they're huge. Can you see that? So this together is measuring at obviously 11 inches. Well, it's actually just over 11 inches. So, yeah, I'd say it was about 11 and a quarter inches. Yeah, 11 and a quarter inches by 8 and a quarter. Yeah, so it's the right length, just a bit bigger the other way, which is weird. Oh my god, how exciting. So we have our book, our album all done, and obviously we are going to colour this, and then we are going to have, I will come back anyway, but we're going to have 6 here. Yeah, I'm going to have 6 here. So, you could colour the inside. I'm not going to, because you can see the spine. I might go over it in white. Just go plain white again. But you're not really going to see it. So, if you don't mind this little bit here, then obviously it's fine. But you're really not going to see it. This bit you will, so maybe do cover it. Actually, if you were to cover it, you would need a piece of paper that is, so this is 8 and a quarter, so I would say I would go 8 1/8, just because you don't want it too long. If you want it the same length, then do 8 1/4, but I'm just going to go that little shorter. And then, I couldn't tell you how big. I think you would need about two pieces of A4, maybe 2 pieces of 12 by 12. Let me just double check that for you. Yeah, so I'm going to put my boxes away, which we will decorate the boxes. We will decorate the front of the album as well. Okay. Might actually need three. Yeah, we will need three pieces of the album still. So you need three to make the album, three to decorate the album. Like that. Okay. And it's literally because you've got a little bit here is why you would need to do another piece. But what I would do, I would do one piece here and one piece here, and then do the other one in the middle, because then you're covering all the spines that you need to cover. But remember, you will need to come back with the right pieces, and then I can show you what I mean. Okay, so I am back, and what I have done is I have covered my edges. So I've covered this side and this side first. And the reason I did that is because you do not want your middle piece to cover these. Otherwise it's going to make this folding so much harder than it needs to be. So I'm going to fold these before I put my middle piece in. So you just want to fold it slightly just to get that like gap. And then just, again, you just need to do that slowly again. I know it's a lot of process of building it slowly, but honestly, it'd be so much worth it in the end. And then you need to find the other one and do exactly the same. Because you're kind of just trying to get that paper to, you just want to get your ruler and do what you did with the first time. And then just make, I did use glue for this bit. Again, you can use tape if you prefer. And then the middle piece, I've literally did a piece of 8 1/4 by 8. So you'll know which way it goes around, because obviously that's a bit smaller. So yeah, when I add this down, it's not going to interact with my spine, which is amazing. And so the middle is 6 if you want to do it exact. I wanted to go 1 inch just over, just to make sure. So this bit here I think is about 6 inches I worked out. But I was just using my ruler with it not stuck down. So, oh, I've done it again. Here we go. See, that's how you know, because it will not be the right way. Right. So we are all done with this bit. I am going to do a part 2. I can see that part 1 is really, really long now. But I will, what I'll do, part 1 will be up today. And then part 2 will be up tomorrow. Because it would be recorded, so, for you guys. Okay, but, yeah, really, really excited to finish. And just think, all we got to do now, add our boxes. Decorate and we are finished. So yeah, hope you all take care, have an amazing day, and I'll see you tomorrow.